Hello everyone, I am Murali Krishna and today we are going to know about web security issues. First of all, what is web security? It basically means protecting a website or web application by detecting and preventing to cyber attacks. We know around the year 2000, the language of internet transitioned from FTP to HTTP. This marked a broad acceptance of World Wide Web. So we know that websites are used by students, teachers, businessmen, or from social media, etc. So even activities as simple as shopping from online for a gift can become a target of a malicious attack. Now, let us see some facts of the attacks happening in the 2021 year. Do you know that in this year, 2021 itself, to June, there are almost 6 lakh cybersecurity incidents happening. These incidents include different types of attacks. Some of the attacks like phishing. What is phishing attack? Phishing attack is where the attacker tries to trick an unexpected victim into handing over valuable information such as password, credit card details, etc. Phishing attacks often arrive in the form of an email pretending to be a form of legitimate organization, such as your bank, tax department, or some other trusted entity. They replicate the original organization so as to trick you. Phishing is probably the most common form of cyber attacks, largely because it is easy to carry out and surprisingly effective. The other type of attacks like distributed denial of service attack. A DDoS attack is where an attacker essentially floods a target server with traffic in an attempt to disrupt and perhaps even bring down the target. However, unlike the traditional DDoS attack, which most sophisticated firewalls can detect and respond to, the attack is able to leverage multiple compromised devices to bombard the target with traffic. One more attack is business email compromise. A BEC attack is where the attacker targets specific individuals, usually an employee who has the ability to authorize financial transactions in order to trick them into the transferring money into an account controlled by the attacker. These attacks usually involve planning and research in order to be effective. For example, an information about the target organization, executives, employees, customers, business partners, and potential business partners with help the attacker convince the employee into handing over the funds. These BEC attacks are one of the most financially damaging forms of the cyber attack. Furthermore, the attacks like drive-by attack. A drive-by download attack is where an unexpected victim visits a website, which in turn infects the device with malware. The website in question could be one that is directly controlled by the attacker or one that has been compromised. As we have known about the different attacks in detail, do you know that Google has registered almost 20 million phishing sites on January 17, 2021? In the first half of 2021, cyber criminals launched approximately 5.4 million DDoS attacks. Imagine, this is only about the first half of 2021. What will be the second half? It will be almost double the part. So, we have seen the different attacks and we have understood that web security is highly essential in the current environment. Let me explain the web security issues with the CIA trade. We all know that the CIA trade means confidentiality, integrity, availability. First of all, confidentiality. Here the threat is information of the client-server conversation leaking or the loss of data from server or client. The results of this threat are loss of privacy, loss of information, etc. To get a clear idea about confidentiality, I'll give an example. Imagine there are two persons, A and B. A is sending messages to B and B is sending messages to A. So here the confidentiality attack is like, the third person, C, can view the messages sent by A and B. So these messages can be something like passwords or credit card details or something highly important data. So these all things can be viewed by C. So what happens here is the privacy of A and the privacy of B are compromised. This is the problem with the confidentiality. Nowadays, many chatting websites or etc. are using encryption techniques so as to give the security. Here the threat is modification of user data, memory, message traffic in transit. The consequences of this are loss of valuable information. The system may become vulnerable to other types of attacks. To understand this, let me give an example. The confidentiality example, I have told you that person A and B are conversing. In the middle, person C have entered and he have spoofed the data of A and B. So he spoofed the data there, but in this integrity, he can also change the data. So due to this, the risk of loss of information or the risk of changing the information, which may lead to different consequences. This can be prevented by using cryptographic checksums. Let us move on to the final one, availability. Here, the threat is filling up disk or memory, flooding attacks, isolating machine by DNS attacks. The consequences of this are denial of service. I have told you earlier, what is denial of service? The prevention of this. Imagine a server. The attacker keep on flooding the server so that the server will become ineffective or due to the heavy traffic that it is taking. There is no certain prevention for this, but you can use some measures like you can know your traffic, you can use continuous monitoring so that any unusual activity can be stopped, or scale your bandwidth. And the main idea is you can use cloud for your storage. As we can know, as you know that by using hard disk or any other hardware, it is difficult to extend the memory. But in the cloud, you can extend the memory by paying or any other form of transaction. I hope you understood my concept.